Well, in your health now, whooping cough, also known as pertussis or the 100-day cough, is described as a highly contagious respiratory illness.
And the number of cases is on the rise. According to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, the number of cases across the country is higher than what we saw at this time last year.
In fact, nearly 27,000 cases have been reported in 2024, the highest number of cases since 2012. 13 Action News reporter Lisa Guyton live with ways to protect yourself and those around you. Lisa.
Lee and Christian, experts say there is a surge in cases across the entire country. The Toledo pediatrician we spoke with says there's no need to panic, but it is time to be proactive.
Whooping cough is a bacterial illness that causes a prolonged cough and really quite a harsh cough. In infants, it can be deadly. So it's really important not to be bringing whooping cough to babies.
Dr. John McBride is with Franklin Park Pediatrics.
A lot of our illnesses are spread by kids in school and they take it home to their parents. Whooping cough is the opposite. It's spread by teenagers and by parents and it's taken home to the babies. So I would certainly urge parents and grandparents of new babies, or if you have someone in your family who's pregnant, now is the time to go out and get a pertussis vaccine.
Experts say symptoms are usually mild at first and are similar to those of a common cold. But unlike a cold, the coughing can last for weeks and even months. And some people have violent coughing attacks that leave them gasping for air. Dr. McBride says there's a simple way to help protect yourself and others.
The main protection is vaccination.
Infants get a series of shots. As for adults,
nobody really gets lifetime protection from either the vaccine or the illness. Most tetanus shots nowadays have a whooping cough vaccine in them. And so hopefully, as adults, we're getting that every 10 years.
Dr. McBride even rolled up his sleeve and got the shot while we were there.
Schedule an appointment with your doctor and go get those simple vaccines that can save you from a lot of unnecessary illness.
The CDC says the bacteria that causes whooping cough are spread easily from person to person through the air. And people can be contagious for weeks after their coughing starts. It is often treated with antibiotics, but experts say to be most effective, that needs to happen before the coughing fits begin. And once again, babies under the age of one are at the greatest risk of getting whooping cough and having severe complications from it. Lee and Christian.